Or whatever.
Hey Dino fans, D-Rex here. Today we're going to take a look at the Dino Rivals Off-Road Tracker ATV with... I was going to say Chris Pratt, but that's Owen Grady, and a Draco Rex. We do also have some little accessories, and of course the vehicle itself is pretty cool. I originally did not have too many vehicles. The vehicles that I have in my, from my original collection are the remote control Mercedes and the remote, I had like, because I had the remote control T-Rex and the remote control Stegosaurus. And so that was the only reason I had the Mercedes. Then later, someone gave me a box of vehicles to go with some Jurassic stuff, and I got Jeep 27 and the Lost World like Dino Trapper thing and the other little ATV vehicle. And I did buy the High Hide, and I did buy the motorbike because I liked that scene in the movie. So I had the motorbike. And then later I got the Jurassic Park Explorers, and I happened to get two of them, so I have two of those on display. And then I have the Lost World Mobile Command Center, the big trailer. So then Jurassic World came around, and they had more remote control vehicles, so I got the Mercedes truck or whatever it is, and I got the Jeep that came out. And then with Mattel, there's three regular vehicles and three RC vehicles and a submarine. And so my vehicle collection is accidentally extensive. I have just about everything. So when they announced that they were going to be making some more vehicles, I thought, well, okay. Completionist in me said, you might as well get this one too, even though I've already got a Draco Rex that I like, and I have way too many Owen Grady's. Having the ATV, I knew if I didn't have it, I would regret it. So here we are. Some cool things to note. They do include a Dino Rivals card in this pack, but you do not get to see what it is until you open it. So I don't know what card this is. They've put it in with the gray side out, so I'm excited to see what that is. I do see that there's a set of instructions in here in the end of the package. And it is, like, fully encased in plastic. So none of the little bits and bobs can get lost. Nobody can break it. Nobody can play with the vehicle or steal any parts of it without destroying the box. So that's nice. It is a very sturdy box. You can see on the back here, we have an illustration of the vehicle capturing the Draco Rex. And we have here the dual attack collection picture. And I just reviewed those dinos, so hopefully that video will be on this channel soon. We do have the footprint icon, so there should be a QR code on the Draco Rex's foot. On the ends of the package, this end has the T-Rex, and this end has the trike with the Dino Rivals logo. And that's the same trike pose that we see in the collector card for the Triceratops. And this is in scale with everything else, like all the Mattel toys. Can't tell you how happy that makes me. And I can't wait to open it up and get a closer look. So, once you remove the outer box, what you have is this little cardboard fold-up thing. And I already removed the plastic lock that was on the bottom. And I'm a little bit perplexed because, they taped this, and I really want to be careful removing it so that I don't damage the card. But as you can see, it is the gray Draco Rex. The best way is to hold it flat and just carefully peel the tape back. And as you can see, our instructions are in the side, and the rest of this is going to be very noisy, so I'm going to cut and bring you back. All right, the Jeep girl in me and the Barbie girl in me are pretty happy right now. I say that because the ATV comes with little accessory packs, and I'll show you. You can take them off and rearrange them because they have little holes on the back of the ATV where you can insert the little peg that's on the back of them. So basically you can rearrange your packs on your bike or your ATV put them wherever you think would be convenient. Comes with two large packs and one smaller pack. And this is pretty much your standard Owen Grady figure. It's exactly like the ones we've seen before, right down to the bullet hole in the back of his belt to put his knife into. The thing that I would say is that this is a much shinier Owen face than I'm used to. I don't know if they've changed the plastic or they had to use more release agent because the mold is getting worn out. I hope the mold is getting worn out. We have way too many Owen Grady figures. They need to make a Barry from Jurassic World or Mercenary Guys or, you know, somebody else. Nothing wrong with Owen Grady, but so far I have 1, 2, 3, 4. I have like 5 or 6 of these. You only need so many. Enough, okay? Make somebody else. The Draco Rex is very much like the Attack Pack Draco Rex. Same mold and same everything, except for the paint is better. Well, sort of. They put the paint on the body this time and not the tail. Whereas the other one has paint on the tail and not the body. Let me grab it here and I'll show you what I'm talking about. Here you go. When you compare the two, you can see the tiger pattern is on just the tail, this one. And the stripes are on the body of this one. So if you put the two paint jobs together, it's perfect, right? Anyway, I do like it, though. I like that they put the stripes on the leg. I wish that this was more detailed. I wish the horns were not black. The paint job on the head could be way better. But the head's poseable. It tilts up and down. And the neck tilts up and down. The arms don't pivot out, but they do go forward and back. And we do have a QR code on the foot. If you look at the two QR codes, you can see that they are different for the two different Draco Rex models. Not a bad little gray Draco Rex. I just wish the paint on the head was done a little bit. I would probably repaint that, to be honest. I would probably make all of his horns white or some other color. Because that kind of just looks like they took a spray can and went right down the front of his nose. Although, they did paint the eyes over the black, so at least he has yellow eyes. Back to this ATV, you can see it has different holes to mount the supply packs in, and you just push them into place. I would imagine, like any toy that has pegs, over time that will wear out during play, but for now it's quite cool. We do have exhaust coming out the back. It does have tilty suspension so that you can drive over bumps and stuff. And if I remove this rubber band from the front, that will unlock the capture claws on the front of the vehicle. Oh, that's so cool. Okay, basically to operate the capture claws, they snap open in an open position, and there's a button in between them. So when you get a dinosaur up in there, it bumps the button and closes the capture claws. On the front of the ATV, there is a Jurassic logo, and it does have stickers where the headlights go. So it does have headlights. It's a pretty cool little ATV, to be honest. Just a quick shot of the bottom here, you can see that they did put the copyright information on the bottom. So you can tell, like, collectors down the road, years from now, will be able to see that this is Amblin and Mattel. The figure does fit very well onto the ATV. There are not foot pegs, and he doesn't sit all the way down unless you push him down in there. His knees do go all the way forward, but he does have handholds on the handlebars for the throttle and the brake. And steering. Let's see what happens when we drive up on Mr. Draco Rex here. I did hit the button. It did start to collapse the claws, but it didn't hit hard enough to do it. So you have to hold... You will have to hold your dino when you're capturing it to fully activate the claws. And before we wrap it up, we do want to take a look at this gray Draco Rex collector card. You can see this is another dynamic pose. It's sort of the opposite of the direction of the other Draco Rex card. The pose is not exactly the same, One has a hand up and one has a hand down. But other than that, they're pretty similar. The thing that is interesting, however, is that the gray Draco Rex has different stats than the yellow one. You can see that the intelligence on the yellow one is 3, and the intelligence on the gray one is only 2. And of course, strength is 4, speed is 6, and attack is 3. But your gray Draco Rex is 1 point weaker than your yellow one, orange one, brown one, whatever color you want to call that. Interesting, interesting. I'm pretty happy with the ATV. It's not all that complex. There's not a ton to it, but it does what it's supposed to do, and it gives you another way to interact with and display your action figures. It would be really nice if they would come out with a few more vehicles. I can think of some that I'd like them to do, like the Explorer, or any of the legacy vehicles would be amazing because I love the Jeep, and so far every vehicle they've done has been fantastic. So, Mattel, if you're watching, make some more vehicles because they're cool. So that is our look at the off-road tracker ATV with chase and catch action features, Draco Rex, and Owen Grady figure. I hope that you've enjoyed today's video. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Hit the bell icon to be notified when I upload a new video because I am on a little bit of a strange schedule as I'm busy with work and family and other things. I will be streaming gaming sometimes, usually on the weekend. And that, if you see that pop up, it's either going to be on YouTube or Twitch. Just search for Debosaurus Rex. And that's an excellent opportunity for us to chat and interact in real time. And it helps me get to know you guys a little better. So I hope to see you there. In the meantime, though, enjoy the Dino reviews and openings and catch up with me on Twitter and Facebook as Debosaurus Rex and also my Jurassic Park Jeep replica JP11D Rex. Until next time, Dino fans, happy hunting.